Hi everyone, welcome. We are talking about some terms today that describe the different parts of the body and also the relation of where things are in the body relative to other parts, right? So we're gonna cover the directional terms, some of the major body cavities, and also the terms that describe different parts of the body. Okay, so first off, I think we need to go over some directional terms because these allow us to describe where things are in the human body. Let's consider this image right here, quick illustration that I drew of the torso of a female. If we're talking about something that is close to the midline of the body, that is called medial. So something that's medial is close to the midline of the body. Something that is lateral is to the side of the body, right? So you could say that the shoulders are lateral to the sternum, right? Now, if we're talking about something that's towards the top of the head, that's superior, and something that's down towards the feet, that's inferior. The terms ventral refer to something that's on the front side of the body, so you can say that the belly button's on the ventral side of the body, whereas dorsal is on the back of the body. Synonyms for ventral and dorsal are anterior and posterior, so you could say that like the face is on the anterior side of the head. Couple other terms that relate to the limbs are proximal and distal. So if we consider this arm right here, if something's closest to where that arm attaches to the torso, that's proximal. If it's further away, it's distal. So you could say that the fingers are distal to the elbow, or the elbow is proximal to the fingers. Lastly, we can talk about superficial and deep. If something is superficial, it's on the surface of the body. If it's deep, it's in the middle of that structure. So like the bones are deep to the skin, okay? Finally, in anatomy, it's useful to kind of cut different structures so we can see what's inside those structures. That's called a slice. A mid-sagittal slice would be like, kind of gruesome, but we would take a saw blade and kind of split this person into an equal right and left half. And that would allow us to see what's inside, like the abdominal cavity, for example. A coronal section is when we slice this human body in a front and back half. So the saw blade kind of comes like this, divide the body into a front and back half. And then finally, a cross section would be like we divide the arm, we cut the arm right here into a top and a bottom half, or a proximal half and a distal half, so we could see the internal structure of that. All right, so that's kind of the basic directional terms. Now what I'm gonna do is we're gonna talk a little bit about the different body cavities that exist inside the human body. So I'm gonna kind of transition down to this illustration right here. This is kind of the lateral view of a male torso. Inside the body, we have these cavities that contain really important things like our organs, obviously, okay? Now there's two major cavities that exist in the human body. You're gonna have the dorsal cavity that encases the brain and the spinal cord. So the dorsal cavity is gonna be shaded in this kind of green color. It's gonna be located right here. That's gonna encase the brain, right? And then it's gonna extend down the spine like this, if I can be careful and not mess up. And extend down the spine like that, and it's gonna encase the spinal cord. So everything in green that I just drew is called the dorsal cavity. The dorsal cavity is actually divided up into two different parts. This part of the dorsal cavity that encases the brain, that's called the cranial cavity. So let me write that out. Cranial cavity is right there. And then the part of the dorsal cavity that encases the spine, that is the vertebral cavity. Vertebral, and he is right there. Now together, those two guys are combined to form the dorsal cavity. So that's cool, but we've got another cavity which is positioned on the front of the body, and that is called the ventral cavity. Surprise, surprise, right? The ventral cavity is gonna be located right about here. I'm gonna draw this more in like a red color. And it's gonna extend down all the way to right about there. Okay, so everything in this like kind of lightish red color, that represents the ventral cavity. Okay, now the ventral cavity is really divided up into three different parts. Up top or more superior, that's where you're gonna have your thoracic cavity. So I don't wanna smear it, but thoracic cavity is going to be located right there. This is going to house your lungs and your heart and your esophagus, and that's about it. Now, below the thoracic cavity, that's where you're going to have the abdominal cavity. Abdominal cavity is going to be located right here. This is where all of your abdominal organs are. Stomach, liver, spleen, pancreas, small intestine, duodenum, all these important things are going to be located in the abdominal cavity. And then finally, as you go more inferior, that's going to lead way to the pelvic cavity. Let's scoot up so you can get this. All right. Pelvic. Pelvic cavity is right there. Now all three of these combine to form the ventral cavity. Ventral cavity. Now, important thing, the thoracic cavity is separated from the abdominal cavity by a thin sheet of muscle. I'll try to draw that in like a slightly darker kind of strip of red if I can do it. That little strip of muscle is called the diaphragm. And so the diaphragm is really located right about there. And that is gonna separate the thoracic cavity from the abdominal cavity. Now in the pelvic cavity, you'll find there, you're gonna find the reproductive organs in both males and females. You're gonna find the bladder and the rectum. And so that is a nice little overview of the different cavities. Now let's kind of switch gears and talk about the names of the different body systems, okay? Or the body regions, excuse me. So I'm gonna go back up to this picture. Actually, you know what? Let's start with the profile of the head. So here is obviously a profile of a female. And each part of the body is going to have a different name. You might be thinking, like, why do we need to know the names of, like, the eye and the ear? Well, they have medical terms, which are really going to help you as this course goes on, because these medical terms are going to help you with the names of the bones of that region, the names of the muscles, the names of the nerves, the names of the vessels. Everything kind of builds upon each other. So this is really important information. Now, the name of the forehead region is called the frontal region. Frontal is going to be located right here. Guess what the name of the bone is right below the skin here? It's the frontal bone, so that makes sense. Okay, the ear, that is called the otic region, O-T-I-C. That's going to be located right there. Okay, the back of the head, that's an important one. That's called the occipital region, O-C-C-I-P-I-T-A-L. Guess what bone is located right here? The occipital bone. So it kind of builds upon each other. The neck is the cervical region, C-E-R-V-I-C-A-L. Guess which vertebrae are in the neck? Cervical vertebrae. The chin is a tricky one. The chin is called the mental region, M-E-N-T-A-L. We'll learn that there's actually two little holes in the bone of the mandible, the bone that's your lower jawbone. These allow for the passageway of blood vessels and nerves. Well, those are called the mental foramen. So really are, this does kind of help build upon each other. The cheek is called the buccal region, B-U-C-C-A-L. The mouth is the oral region, O-R-A-L. The nose is nasal, there's no surprise there. N-A-S-A-L. Okay. What else? The eye is not optic. A lot of people think that the eye is the optic region. It's actually the orbital region. So O-R-B-I-T-A-L. That's going to be located right there. Good. And that pretty much does it for the head. So that's kind of a good starting place to kind of work from right there. Now, if we kind of transition over to this view of the female, let me see, make sure it's in view here. Yep, perfect. This view of the female torso, we can really start to describe some of the other parts of the abdomen and of the arms and the legs. First off, we know this is the cervical region, right? Now, when we get down here, right here where the sternum is, that's called the sternal region. Sternal region is located right there. Now, the shoulder is called the deltoid. Now, the deltoid muscle is right there. So the deltoid region of the shoulder is really this meaty part of the arm. So we'll say deltoid is right there. But you'll notice that there's this hard little bony bump right on the top of the shoulder, right about there. That is called the acromial region, and that's because the bone that makes that little bump is called the acromion. So this is the acromial region, A-C-R-O-M-I-A-L, right up top. All right, as we go down, what we'll find is that this is the mammary region. So mammary region is located right there. The umbilical region is the belly button. Umbilical region is right there. Perfect. The abdominal region is this whole region right there that contains the abdomen. I don't really need to even label that. Well, I will. Abdominal region is all in here. Good. Now, as we get down towards the pelvis, the pubic region is exactly where you would expect it to be. So the pubic region is going to be right here. But the groin, so the groin, which is this region right here between the legs, where the legs meet the torso, that is called the inguinal region. So I-N-G-U-I-N-A-L. The inguinal region is right there, and it really occupies this space right there where the legs meet the torso. Good. All right, now what else do we need to talk about? Okay, as we go down, the upper leg is called the femoral region. Guess what the name is of the largest artery of the upper leg? Femoral artery, right? The bone of this region, the femur. I mean, so these all really kind of build upon each other. The knee is the patellar region. What's the name of your kneecap? The patella, okay? Then of the lower leg actually has two different parts. The front of the lower leg is called the crural region, C-R-U-R-A-L. And the back of the lower leg, which we'll label in a different picture, that's called the sural region. So that's a pretty good overview of those different parts of the body. Perfect, right? Oh, I think we forgot one more. The pectoral region is right here. I'm not even going to label that because we don't really need to, and that'll be good for now. Now, if we transition over here to the arm, we can label some more details of the arm. This is going to be a kind of an anterior view of the male arm. We know that this is the deltoid. We know this is the acromial region. We haven't talked about the armpit. The armpit's called the axillary region. Axillary region is going to be located right there. Guess what the name of the artery that goes through your armpit? Axillary artery. The upper arm, this is going to be called the brachial region. B-R-A-C-H-A-L. Now the elbow has two different names. The back on the posterior side of the elbow, that's called the olecranon region. O-L-E-C-R-A-N-O-L. Olecranon. The bone that makes up your elbow, that's called the olecranon, so that kind of makes sense. And then the front, or the anterior side of the elbow, that's called the antecubital region. Antecubital, which is right there. The forearm as a whole is called the antebrachial region. The wrist is carpal. Think about carpal tunnel, right? That's inflammation of the flexor tendons in your wrist. So the carpal region is going to be located right there. The thumb has a special name. He's called pollex. And then the fingers, they are called the digital region. I misspelled that. Okay, digital. You guys know what digital, how that's spelled. And then the palm, which you really can't see there, that's called the palmar region, which you can't really label. Well, whatever, I'll try. The palmar region is right there. All right, so that's a pretty good overview of the arm. I don't think we missed anything. Now we can finally kind of transition over here. So this is going to be an illustration of the posterior view of a person. Now there's a couple of different terms that we haven't talked about. So the scapular region is going to refer to where the shoulder blades are. The scapula is the name for the shoulder blade, so that really kind of, that makes sense. You're going to have the vertebral region right here. Right where the spine is. As you go inferior, the vertebral region gives way to the sacral region. Guess what bone is located right there at the base of the spine? That's your sacrum, okay? The rear end, right, is the gluteal region. That's where your gluteus maximus is, and on the side of the gluteus medius, so it's a great kind of start learning those muscles. The side of the hip right there, that's actually called the coxal region. C-O-X-A-L. We had mentioned already that the upper leg is called the femoral region. Now this is important, the back of the knee, this is called the popliteal region. P-O-P-L-I-T-E-A-L. Guess what the name of the artery is in the back of the knee? The popliteal artery. Guess what the name of the little muscle is located right here? The popliteus. Perfect. Back of the lower leg, that's the sural region. Perfect. We got the ankle is gonna be the tarsal region. So the ankle is going to be right there. The back of the heel, right there, that's the calcaneal region. Calcaneus bone is located right there. Bottom of the foot is the plantar region. Think about plantar fasciitis. That's when the fascia or the connective tissue on the underside of your foot becomes inflamed and it is very painful. All right, now that pretty much does it. Oh, the big toe has a special name. I think that you can barely see the big toe. He is called the hallux, which is right there. The other toes are called digitals, just like the fingers. So that, I believe, is a really good overview. I don't think I missed any of the body regions. I probably did, though. And that is all right, because you have that in your lab list, but at the very least, this will give you kind of an overview of what everything looks like. I'll kind of review everything. Here's the front of the torso. Here are the different body cavities. And you have the regions related to the face, the arm right here, and the posterior side of the body. Okay, that's it. Thanks.